Well, that's two in a row. That's a little nicer feeling, isn't it?
Yeah, it certainly is. This time of year when, you know, you're kind of getting to the dog days and working through December now and December football, you really need to be hitting your stride, I think, as a football team. So for us to get two in a row now to start December, now we can hopefully push through, and we'd love to finish just winning them all.
I was in the news conference after the game. Zim is not a happy guy. He's not. Yeah. He's hard to please.
He wants us to play well. You know, that's the biggest thing is he wants you to win, of course, every game, but he wants you to play well and win. You know, it's one thing to play well and lose, you know, and had put your best foot forward, but for us, you know, we could have played so much better, you know, and we know that, and coming into today is just about, you know, awareness of how much we could have played better.
You had double digits in tackles. Is that something you look at and say, I had a decent game because I was that involved, or is that a product of the defense?
No, I think it's one of those games. It depends on how you're making those tackles. You're making them in around the line of scrimmage is certainly helpful, which was more like what I did yesterday. So, yeah, it's a productive game. I mean, you know, linebackers are paid to make tackles, so that's a good day.
And your guy Gerald Hodges came up big time right off the bat.
Yeah, huge play. I mean, to get a start and get 7 points on the board, 12 seconds in, you know, awesome. Great play, right place, right time. And to make the play is an impressive catch and run.
The good thing about a young guy like Gerald Hodges is that he's got potential. The bad thing is someday he might replace an old veteran.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, no, he's a great player. And when I stepped out for my injuries and he stepped in for me, he played great. Now he's stepped in for Anthony and played great. So, you know, he's got a ton of ability. That's how this league works. You know, young guys come in and when they get an opportunity to play well, you know, that's how it works. So, you know, just have to hopefully continue to play well myself and just let the chips fall.
At what time in your career do you start looking at that, looking over your shoulder?
I think you almost have to every year. You know, even like the first or second year you're in the league, you start, you know, they're always bringing in new talent, new guys coming in right away. So this league, you can never really be comfortable.
You never get to call your shots in this league. Is that something you want to do? When you step away, it's when you want to step away, not when somebody tells you.
Well, that's the goal. My agent, you know, a long time ago told me if you want to do that, you have to get out a year before they want you to, you know, to be able to call your shot and get out. But, you know, I'd love to be able to, I've said it 1,000 times, I'd love to be able to finish my career as a Minnesota Viking. That's really my number one goal at this point in my career. You know, I may not be able to control that, but, you know, I can control how I play right now and control how the season ends.
So you feel you got some tread left on the tire?
Absolutely. Yeah, you know, you can't be, you know, we're what, 13 games into this season. The body feels pretty good, and you know, I feel like I can play some good football.
Zim said after the game that this is Teddy Bridgewater's franchise. Your reaction to that?
Well, he certainly played well. I mean, there's times when he can look like a rookie, no doubt. But you know, Teddy's been as good as advertised, I think, in tough spots, tough situations, and like I said, he's had his rough spots, but he's shined through pretty bright here his last couple games.
It kind of amazed me when he threw the touchdown pass to Jarius Wright. He wasn't even celebrating. Does that surprise you? I mean, he was pretty calm after that.
That's just kind of a reflection of him and his personality. You know, it's almost like he expected to do it and to get the ball to Jarius like that in that situation. Clearly, Jarius did the majority of that work in our offensive line, getting out and blocking. But, you know, good throw, good read, and let your players make the plays. That's really sometimes what a quarterback's his job is.
Does he remind you of anybody that you've come across in your career?
You know, I think you see, you know, the way he kind of handles himself and the way his approach to the offense and when he's standing over the line and kind of looking over the defense, I can't tell you that he's reminds me of one person in particular, but he just has that calm about him, that the confidence and I think it shines through in the, from being calm. You know, he's confident in what he's doing. He knows what he wants to do with the football, and now his accuracy is really coming along.
Have you seen a crazier year in the NFL? You guys beat Carolina. They go down to New Orleans and win by 31.
Yeah, crazy. You know, you see, I saw that result yesterday after our game, and I just couldn't believe what had happened. You know, to go into New Orleans, and they had lost, what, 4 games in a row, I think, you know, down there at home. So, you know, tough situation for them, but it's just a crazy NFL, that's for sure.
Fine line, really fine line between being 6-10 and 10-6.
There always is every year. You know, that's why there's so many teams in and around that 500 mark. It's just so hard to get to that elite level, you know, 13-3, 12-4. You know, a lot of teams around that 10-6 to 6-10, you know, mark. And the year we went 10-6 here in 2012, you know, we were sitting there at 6-6. And you win 4 in a row to finish to get to 10-6. So it's all about that December football. You have to give yourself a chance in December.
It's going to be tough to make the playoffs if you're not already eliminated, but you just want to finish strong.
Yeah, I think we still have an opportunity. We don't control control that other than the fact that we have to win all of our games. But even then, we still don't control our destiny. So, you know, we put ourselves in that position. You know, you can't feel sorry for yourself and the fact that, you know, we had an opportunity to win all those games. You know, the close ones that we let slip away that would have given us an opportunity. So it's tough. It stinks. You know, we're just going to try to take care of our business and win out.
You have not yet beaten a team with a winning record. That's one that you have to accomplish yet this year.
Yeah. I think that, you know, we're going to have an opportunity now, at least these next two, I think, if Miami's still in the positive. But, you know, we have to win a division game, and that starts with the Lions this week.